and welcome to Spicoli TV, live from a shed somewhere in Tampa, Florida. So sit back in your chair and turn up the volume. It's time to laugh. And if you're not careful, you may learn something. So for the next 2 hours, let Spicoli and Smitty entertain you. Call area code 813-402-6724 to participate in madness. And now you're close to Spicoli. My job is done here. I think I'll go play with Smitty's balls.
Warning, the following content may contain elements that are not suitable for some audiences. Viewer discretion is advised.
Spicoli TV, Friday nights right here, 9 p.m. every Friday. We just crowned a new Snapple Cap champion. Hard to believe, 3 years Minnesota was the champion. Came in here, bought one of these plastic bottles, and just like that, we had a new champion. Geo! From Scotland, the new Snapple Cap Fact Champion. You could be that one if you want to. Friday nights, come check us out and read numbers like 1124. Wasn't that a number I missed? 1124? I think it was. I don't know. NoNameNetwork.net, SpicoliTV.com, IRNBroadcast.com. Go check those places out. If you get lost, just go to SpicoliTV.com. There's a Friends and Link page. It connects all of our friends and all of the places to go. IRN Broadcast 24/7 podcast. 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. I don't know too many places that offers that. Go check them out. You'll find something you like. I know I did.
Hey, you're watching Spicoli TV. And now back to the show. Take it away, Spicoli, you freak. Right back at you.
I'm Ben Matlock. I want a hot dog. Welcome, welcome. Welcome into the hot dog show of the world. No, it is not Quincy, it is Matlock. I am your host, Spicoli, sitting here in the driver's seat of the euphoria cage that we call the shed. Now I want a hot dog for real. I am your host, and over here is the guy that helps me do things, and boy, is this strange staring up into a corner, but I like this. It's weird. So, this guy is weirder than me, and, you know, he helps me move things along. His name is Smitty. He's over here somewhere. Over here? Here. No, there.
Yeah.
Yeah, there he is. Look at the colors popping tonight. Wow. Nice.
Yep.
I picked up my orange shirt, and I said, nah, you never know. You never know.
He always wears orange.
Hi, Spicoli. I don't see Smitty. He's over there.
I'm here now.
He's the guy over here. He sees dead people. See, my orange almost matches your shirt.
Yeah.
Almost.
Almost.
Pert near. Nice bright color, girls. Thank you.
Shows. If I'm a female, then the show's over because I've got to go touch things.
What you gonna touch?
Whatever I get. All right. That's fucking great.
That's great. I finally wanted one. I've been trying to get one of these my whole life.
I'm gonna have to call my boss. Time I ain't coming in.
I'm gonna be late. Why? Because you know I got this new toy, and I'm gonna play with it for a while.
What was it, Woody and Buzz Lightyear?
Woody and Buzz Lightyear.
Those were the name of Mom's vibrators.
And Woody and Mom's.
George Romero. Yeah, that's terrible. Yeah. That's sad.
How does that happen?
Well, he was an old man. Was he 89, 80, 88, 89 years old?
Some band guy.
No, George Romero was the original Walking Dead. Or not Walking Dead. Night of the Living Dead. He did the original Night of the Living Dead.
Yeah, I know who he is.
He did Night of the Living Dead and Dawn of the Dead.
He did a lot of those. He did a lot of things, man.
I like the old one, and I like the new one, too. They were pretty good.
I like the old one. No, there was a Linkin Park singer that died.
Yeah, that guy, too.
Yeah.
What the hell's going on with people?
I don't know, man.
They're falling off like fleas.
Yeah.
Picking them across America.
Chester some shit or another.
Chester. I thought that was a joke when it said Chester. I'm like, Chester, yeah. Where did he get that? Was his parents a Looney Tunes fan? Chester.
No, he reads Penthouse because it wasn't that
Chester
the Molester?
The Child Molester.
Yeah,
yeah.
Chester
One of the
Molester.
Greatest cartoons ever.
Who names their kid Chester?
That's what I'm saying. Who names the kid Chester? Little Chester.
That's too funny. I wonder how popular that name really is.
How popular at that time, and what other names were popular at that time that Chester was around? Agnes? You think Agnes was
Samson?
A swinging hick lady's tune?
Ethel?
Ethel. Who bangs a chick named Ethel? Oh, Ethel.
I'm going on a blind date with a chick named Ethel.
Oh! She's blind? Yeah, she can't see nothing. I run circles around her, literally.
There was a girl I went to school with. Her name was Bianca Dollar.
Nuh-uh.
Bianca Dollar.
Bianca?
Dollar.
Dollar. Yep. D-O-L-L-A-R?
Yep.
Spelled the same way.
Bianca Dollar, yeah.
Wow.
She was ugly.
Oh, I was about to say.
Wow.
She's got dreams of being a stripper with
Whoa,
a name like that.
Oh, man.
Her name's going to be Not Make a Dollar.
Phyllis, too, yeah. You got to pay me to stay, honey.
I can't make fun of Phyllis. That was my grandmother's name.
Well, I understand that,
but
that was those
but
old
that was,
names.
That was those names that were.
That's what they were.
Yeah, I mean, there was a lot of key.
Now the names are really weird.
Oh, they're getting weirder.
Lake and Blue and
people just fucking
North.
See a name written somewhere and they go, "I'm going to name my son
Erase.
Wexford, little Wexford, little Wexford."
He's from
up.
London for sure. Lada Monica,
Lada Monica. Lamangelo, K Martina, Salmonella,
Lamangelo.
Aloe Vera, Maybelline. I mean, they just
like
name them
now.
After anything now.
Anything.
It's ridiculous.
Yeah.
They just
Brittany.
Throw
oh,
it up in the air.
My not like that.
My girl's name's going to be Butt Wiza.
Sharpie. I thought Brittany was a nice name.
Name.
Megan's pretty good.
You should have named your daughter, My Daddy's Gonna Kill You.
You're gonna have a what?
My
I do.
Daddy's Going to Kill You. Just plain and simple.
Money.
Give me free.
Monica?
Monica?
Monica? Monica.
Free Monica.
Blanket.
Blanket. No shit. That's...
Come here, blanket.
Don't forget to bring a towel. What? You wanna get high?
No.
No. Don't forget to bring a towel.
Blanket. Why did he name his kid Blanket?
Blanket, come here.
I know who we're dealing with here. We're dealing with Michael Jackson, but Blanket?
Isn't his other kid's name Pillow?
Did they just throw it in a goddamn raffle thing and whatever comes up? Let's throw a bunch of names in a hat. Oh, look, somebody said toilet plunger.
No, he was going, all those children I've molested, what's been in common?
Oh,
I did it on top of the blanket.
On top of the blanket.
Your blanket.
Oh, Lord.
No, I don't believe he did it. How about OJ, man?
How about OJ? Got to give it a little love to OJ. I heard OJ could be coming to Florida.
Yep.
To Tampa, even.
Naples.
Naples.
Yeah.
Keep on going, Juice. We don't
That's
need
right.
you. We're going to have to play the Juice calls now.
You heard what he said, right?
Yeah.
What?
I'm going to play some golf.
My life's been friction-free. You know,
find a real killer.
Yeah. That. How come he hasn't said that?
If I was him, I'd go look up Cato.
But why isn't he ever saying
Yo, that? Yo, Cato, I'm coming to stay with you for a while.
Why isn't he going... you know, we really need to start getting back into that case and, you know, trying to find some new evidence on who killed. Nah.
Because he figures it's all over with.
It doesn't matter, but if you really didn't do it,
the only reason he
you'd
was,
still want to know who did it.
The only reason he did 9 years is because them motherfuckers took his Heisman Trophy and stole it, and he was pissed off. Hey, I need that trophy. That's my Heisman, bitch. Nobody outruns OJ.
Woo!
I don't know, man. The guy
I ran through an airport, America.
Woo!
You know what happened, right? You saw what happened now.
Yeah.
You know who he said the first guy he talked to in jail?
No.
The dude that he robbed.
Really? He saw him in
that
jail?
That did all that memorabilia stuff?
Wow.
He goes, call me, because what he's going to do is set up an immediate autograph tour. OJ's going to start signing shit all over the
Why
place.
Not?
He's going to make millions.
Why wouldn't he have his own reality show before it's over?
Stop whining.
He'll do that, too. Dude, he could charge $100 a meet and greet autograph.
Why not?
$200, he could charge anything.
They got cameras that follow people around all the time now. He could be the next bounty hunter. OJ the bounty hunter.
Freeze, bitches.
Hey, I got to go make this golf shot real quick, but then I'm going to come back and bust you.
If you're still here, wink, wink.
OJ the bounty hunter. That would be great. We'll hook him up with Dog the bounty hunter. They can work side by side, teach each other the ropes. And next thing you know, OJ, I'm going to bust your ass.
OJ acts
Don't make me run for you, fool. I'm a little old.
OJ, it's hilarious. OJ acts white and Dog acts black. And that'd be the perfect damn pair.
They could make a movie, man.
What's up, bro? Gee, I don't know what's going on.
I'm the juice. He's the dog. We're going to bust your ass. What? I don't know. Where's your wife with them big-ass titties? Bring her around more often.
But he says he's 26G a month. I saw it was his salary was, you know,
yeah,
not
but
bad.
That's right now. It goes. His pension goes up as he gets older.
Well, 300 grand a year is not bad.
$26,000 a month.
I mean, I can get by on that.
$300,000 a year?
I can get by on that.
You think?
I can get by
comfortably on that.
Yeah, I can get by. Play some golf. Have some fun.
I'm going to look for the real killer. If he's on the golf course, I'll find him. Damn, we can't even play golf once a year. This motherfucker can play every day.
That's all he'll do. And sign autographs. He'll do an autograph signing a day.
And yeah, that's like $100 a pop, though. Yeah.
Yeah, but I think when he makes money, the Goldmans are going to get it.
Wow. I don't know, man. Whatever.
You do it for free with a donation.
He did time. He's 70 some odd years old. Leave the guy alone. Let him. If you're going to let him out, let him be and just leave him alone. I know a lot of people don't agree with him being out. Fuck it. He did his time. Yeah, but, you know, he didn't do his time for. He got acquitted. He got acquitted for his other fucking crime. Leave him be. There's nothing you can do. Let it go.
Doesn't affect me. As long as OJ don't come over
Charles
there
Manson
house.
Didn't kill a motherfucker. He just talked people into killing people. And he's been serving a life sentence. Because he's crazy. But
he'll never get out.
No. All right, the only
ready?
Way he comes out is when they put his body in a fucking little ambulance and drive it out underneath the thing.
That's right.
All right, well, I guess it's been 1 week. It's time to defend that championship. Here we go.
Hey, man, want to play a game? Cool, let's play a game.
Kids, this week's Snapple Cap Fact coming up right now. Don't go anywhere.
Snapple Cap Fact time, kids. Snapple Cap Facts come 0 through 1,499. Let's go a little higher. I don't know what else to do anymore. First one in always gets two guesses. Nitwit.tv has busted that wide open. Geo is defending his chant, his title, if you will. Minnesota, the three-time champion, looking to get his belt back. If you're a guest on the board, you can play along. You can put in a number. Feel free. See a lot of numbers coming in. I'm sure there could be more, though. Come on, guys.
Yep.
Last 10 seconds.
All right, we don't have a number from Minnesota.
Special thanks to Alfonso's Pizza for hooking me up with the pepperoni tonight.
Pepperoni pizza. Minnesota.
Minnesota? Fuck it, I'm not playing. I think he's sitting it out, Jack.
He could have the record for winning this week and taking away somebody in 1 week versus 2 weeks.
4-6.
Because Kirk, remember, Kirk was only the champ for 2 weeks.
I know.
He just got a taste of it.
Just received his championship trophy and bam! Gone.
All right, you ready?
New plastic bottle in the first round. Mango Madness. Mmm. Goes fine with the pepperoni pizza. That's a weak pop. You're right.
They're never going to be the same.
The plastic are terrible. The pops are horrible.
Yeah. We should have recorded that. Could have just played it.
Yeah.
Fake. Just, they'd never know. Sound or click.
Real fact number. This is a long one. One. 198. The U.S. is the largest country named after a real person, Amerigo Vespucci. I remember that in school. Do you remember that?
How did he get picked?
Amerigo Vespucci. I remember that name. Vespucci.
What did he do? I mean, what did he do to get the country named after him?
I don't know. Amerigo Vespucci. That's what your name. Yeah.
I cook a really good food.
Well, 198.
But hold on. We had a close one there, Geo, with 367. That's the closest.
Sorry, Shane.
But I like the fruit punch, man, so. Very weak pop.
Those are terrible.
They will be. But it's a good drink, man. Tasty. Fruit punch. Almost down it.
What did Sticky Jello read what he said on the board?
It's going to be in the 1300s.
Real fact number 1397.
1397.
Gorillas burp when they are happy. We had this on Factor Bullcrap.
Yep.
We had no factor bullcrap.
We did have it on factor bullcrap.
Because I said gorillas are happy when they fart. And everybody, yeah, I'm happy when I fart.
Hell yeah.
That's crazy. So that's an actual fact.
It's been backed up. It's 2-for-2. Nitwit was closest with 11:24.
There it is. I'm going to take a picture of it, put it on Twitter during the break, get a close-up of it. Somebody guesses how many are in there. We'll give you three picks. Three picks. But not
closest
right now.
Closest one.
Closest one.
Closest one to guess how many Snapple cap
can't
facts
go over,
are in
though.
That.
Can't go over.
It's Price is Right rules.
It's Price is Right rules.
Closest.
There's a lot in there.
Without going over.
Mm-hmm. I don't know. Nom, nom, nom.
Well, you know, it could be a while before we have another champ.
That's true.
Geo may have his
reign. He could be the champ for the next 10 years.
Now, Geo, you're going to have to...
Why, you think we'll still be doing this in 10 years?
You have to send us your address.
Yeah.
So we can get your trophy over to you.
What you'll need to do is get a hold of me on the Facebook Messenger and get me your address.
Yep.
And then I'm going Monday to finalize what I want on the trophy and everything. And then we'll send it out to you in the mail.
I could give it up and say I cheated. He cheated. 1397. I knew it! Look, Minnesota, I'll send you something too, Gio. A pile of damn Minnesota's grass. Eat that, bitch.
Here, eat this, and then go drive a long ways.
You'll shit for days. Rest area, 30 miles, I'll never make it.
You're not supposed to eat that stuff. I just sent it to you in the mail.
That was decoration. I was hoping y'all put it up on the board with the toilet paper. Yeah, nice little gift there from old Minnesota. A roll of toilet paper. Nice. Thank you, Minnesota.
That's one ply.
Yeah, and this was also Minnesota.
The dick.
Nose. That was Nitwit.
Yep. Nitwit.
I know you can't see it.
I love that song.
How's the tree coming? The tree is no longer.
Nope.
It died.
It didn't like being in here in the heat, and when I took it out, it never recovered.
It just never recovered. It grew up, man. It grew as big as a Snapple bottle. Yep.
It got big as hell.
And then it died.
Once the heat came...
It started getting little brown spots on it, and that was the end of it.
Mm-hmm.
It never stopped. It just was done. It's like I think somebody poisoned it.
No, Miyagi say, well, you're not supposed to have a bonsai tree in the heat. It no like that. You're supposed to put on side of hill in California where it get misty water in morning and
the
cool.
Fog and smog.
Yes, stay cool and dry.
Well, I don't know. I wouldn't do a plant like that, man. That's too hard. I can't keep up shit like that. Did I water it? Did I not water it? Should I pour my beer in there? I mean, you know. It was a bonsai tree.
Bonsai tree. It was a little palm.
Yeah.
It was a
great
California
grand oak.
Bonsai, yeah.
Yeah.
It turned out nice. It grew out when it started. It was really nice.
Yeah.
Because the weather was cool. It was growing prime.
Summer hit and bam.
Yeah, summer hit and that motherfucker.
Stan pissed on it. He may have.
Yeah.
He was here.
He may have. He was here.
Damn. All right.
That's true.
What other funny names can you think of, man? We were talking about that earlier. You have funny names.
For
people, man. They got Moon Zappa.
Yeah. What was he thinking?
Come here, Moon.
My name's Frank. I'm going to name my kid Moon.
That's how fucked up he was. He's like, I don't know, man. What do you want to call it? He laid back and saw the moon. Moon, man. Yeah, that's great. Moon Unit. Yeah.
Moon Unit. What the hell? That's some good acid.
It was indoors, Minnesota. That's what we're saying. It was indoors.
It was indoors.
It was in the shed.
But it didn't like the heat.
Yeah, the shed's not
climate
controlled.
And I brought it in the house because it was too hot in here. And even in the house,
that's
it's 76 degrees. Yeah. It wouldn't stay cool. It's got to be even cooler.
Yeah.
I know.
I think he might have touched it with chlorine in his hands.
I did not.
And that's what did
I
it.
I did not. I
he
know.
Oozes chlorine.
I
Y'all can't smell
the
that.
The hard way that you clean your hands before you touch, I mean, your penis. I mean, yeah.
After.
You always clean your hands first before you get the chlorine off of there.
Yeah.
Would you name your kid Snapple?
No, but they named it Espen. Remember that? Espen.
Espen, that is stupid.
They're all stupid. North and...
Sup.
I don't know. Hey, North.
Name my kid Sup. Sup!
Come here, Sup.
Sup. Yo! What? Sup!
What if you named him Get Over Here? And you go, Get Over Here! And he's like, me? Yeah, get over here.
Get over here, goddammit. Dad, my name's Jesus Christ.
Yeah, whatever.
Jesus Christ, will you get over here?
Son of a bitch.
I don't know, man. There's so many different things that are better than what people, my kid will be named Plastic Snapple the Turd.
I'm going to name him 345. Come here, 345.
No pop on plastic. Nope. Plastic, no pop.
Oh, you know what's funny about that? I played pick three and got 345 and it won.
Uh-uh.
And I got $1,100. Yeah, Saturday.
What'd you do with $1,100?
Strip club! Day shift!
I went and saw naked people.
Day shift,
yeah,
man. Those,
man,
hey, they're...
Right. Yeah.
Mouse King in there.
Prego.
No.
I'm going to drive any day. Alexis, look. Take your kid off the stage when you go.
Name them all George, like Foreman, yeah. But then he calls him by a nickname. It's like, well, why didn't you just name him the nickname?
I know, it doesn't make no sense.
Your name is George, but I'm going to call you Pookie from now on.
What? You're George Pookie.
Just name me Pookie then.
Yeah, well,
I mean,
well, I got to be George.
You call me Delilah, but you're going to name me George.
Delilah Pookie.
God.
George.
I don't get that.
I don't know.
Jamaicans do it, too.
I don't understand why you be talking to me like that, man.
Why you calling me Sandy?
My own name is Henry, policeman. Yeah. Why you telling me that?
Where's
now?
The bobsled?
Well, I don't want to watch Jamaican bobsled. I heard we could win a gold medal. Sanka and myself, we're going to go down there.
Cock pucky.
It's no fun.
It's a no fun.
It's a no fun. All right, let's go. Round two.
Hey, man, want to play a game?
I got to find the stuff, so I'm kind of pausing for time here. While
cool, let's play a game.
I downloaded more than I wanted to. There we go.
Spinny, Hockey, are you ready to try to match McCoy, you dumbass?
Name of the game is Matt Spicoli. Where's my board? I got a board here. You got a marker? I got a marker. Just write down any random word there, Spicoli. It doesn't really matter. You can write half-eaten pizza, and it wouldn't matter at this point, right? Because that's basically it, right?
Smitty's here, so it's not PG. Are you saying I'm the problem?
You're not the problem. There's no problem. What problem?
I'm the problem.
What problem? All right, what I'm going to do is put a word with a blank in the board.
Yep.
And if you match me, you get the point. I got 10 of them. 1 point for the first one all the way up to 10 with a tiebreaker if needed. All right?
Easiest game to score because nobody ever matches you.
No, exactly. So it's very easy. I mean, anybody can win at any given time. It's like hitting the lottery, kids. Ready? Blank cheese. Blank cheese. Cheese.
Just nitwit. Who cut the cheese?
Blank cheese.
What was the cap fact number. It was 198 and 1397. We had a couple of close calls, but no winner. Nitwit and Geo.
10 more seconds. Blank cheese.
When I'm going to take a picture, you say,
cheese! Oh, wide right as usual. Blank cheese, Smitty.
I said grilled cheese.
Grilled cheese. I said stinky cheese.
Stinky cheese. What the hell? You could have said stinky cheese. Jesus Christ.
Stinky cheese. Stinky cheese. Who cut the cheese? Is that the same?
Stinky cheese.
Who cut the cheese and stinky cheese? Is the same?
No. I don't know what you were thinking. What were you thinking?
Stinky cheese.
All right, stinky cheese.
What name
blue
is,
cheese smells.
Have you ever smelled fucking, whatchamacallit?
Whatchamacallit?
You know, whatchamacallit?
Yeah.
Keep wanting to say Fromunda, but it ain't.
AKA
Fromunda.
Pussy.
No, what's that
Fromunda cheese smells.
It does. It stinks. It smells.
That's
like,
why they call it that.
Smells like fucking feet.
If you name your daughter Fromunda, she's gonna be ugly. Come here, Fromunda!
Fromunda and Lindberger. Thank you, guest 557. Lindberger. You ever smell Lindberger?
No, but
that's
I know.
That's some stinky fucking cheese right there, Jack.
I know a girl named Fromunda Jackson. She lived down the street.
Wait, wasn't she on Good Times?
Fromunda. Lamona's sister.
I started getting down with JJ the other night. Woo! Where's Malona?
Lindberger, that's right.
You ready?
Tastes good, though.
Blank soap.
No, he's like, smells like shit, but it tastes good. So why not eat something that smells good and tastes good?
Yes, exactly.
They have those out there, people.
Blank soap.
Overmodulating on the No Name Network. Bad.
Huh. That's really? Weird. Huh. Because our fucking feed right here is pretty good.
Well, something could be rolling the output, I guess. Maybe. I don't know.
It's fine on Vaughn. Hmm. All right. I'm sorry. I don't know how to correct that. All right. Blank soap, Smitty.
I use it every day.
Everybody uses this soap every
well, this
some form of soap.
I use this type of soap every day.
Hand soap?
You know, bar soap maybe, something okay, like that. Bar yeah. soap. I said laundry soap, though.
Laundry soap.
Laundry soap.
Who doesn't use laundry soap? Laundry soap, Smitty! Laundry is my life. Two-pointer right there. Did anybody else say laundry soap?
Nope.
No, me and Smitty, the only ones. Laundry is my life. Give yourself 2 points. All right, finally a match. The game's not as stupid as you thought it was. Kids, is it?
We'll know
his next answer. He's really going to fuck it up now.
Minnesota says it's good on his end. Cock soap.
Oh, never drill a hole in a soap.
Not as good as it really feels. I mean,
no, but it's all right.
It's all right, but it's...
It's a good feeling.
Thought it was going to be different early on.
It looked great on the drawing until you got there, and you're like, what the fuck?
Laundry? What the fuck? Where's Joey? Hey, sorry, Minnesota.
Beer blank. Beer blank.
Beer sure makes my asshole hurt. Gnip gnop.
Wow!
You're kidding me all these years. Gnip gnop? Yeah, bro, that's ping pong backwards.
What the fuck? It's Gnip. Oh my god, he's right. Gnip, Gnop, just what? Ping
there's a ping pong ball in the damn game.
Crazy, wasn't it?
It's fucking nuts. When did they invent that game? Early 70s?
Yep.
Beer blank, Smitty.
Beer goggles.
Beer goggles.
Make that ugly bitch look like a
goddess. I said something a little different. Beer pong. Beer pong.
There's a couple that said that.
I almost said beer keg. Nobody said beer keg. I'm glad I didn't.
It's all they went, beer keg? Why would you say beer keg?
Beer pong. Nitwit, Sticky Jello, and guest 9557. 3 points.
Nitwit. He came in after the answer was up. I'm going to take those points away.
No, I actually saw his answer before, so. The delay was not happening. If we were on the old stream,
no,
it would have been a delay
so.
And it would have gotten away with it, but not now. All right, you ready?
Yep.
Blank party. Blank party.
Oh, Geo. That's terrible.
Cock party? No, don't say it. I wrote a paragraph. Sausage party.
Yeah.
Yuck. I'm not going to that party, Smitty.
I've said
this. I like sausage on the grill.
That's nice.
But that's the only place.
Cut up. I'm cutting that
motherfucker. I'm cutting that motherfucker up. Blank party, Smitty.
I've said this a time or two. Got some coke. Want a party?
Ooh, that's a great answer.
Got some coke.
Got some coke.
Woo!
Want a party?
Hell yeah! I said, get it.
What?
Hell woo! Yeah!
I said,
keep
birthday party.
Birthday
party. Sticky Jello. Guess 9557.
Wow. They're working together.
Working together. It's collaborate.
Collaborator. You goddamn collaborator.
Is there a rule on that? Can I get a ruling?
Can I get a ruling on that? Can I look at a replay?
Is there a collaboration rule?
Goddamn collaborator going on right there.
Five pointer. 7-7. 3-2. Nitwit got 3. Smitty with 2.
No swallowing at the Geo party.
Fine.
Ice blank. Ice blank. Ice, blank, ice, baby. Ice, JJ Fish.
You can't just say JJ.
You have to say
it's
the
JJ.
Whole thing. Ice, baby, ice cream.
Woo!
I see a train going, Smitty. You want to ride the train?
No, it's pretty easy. I mean, I love ice cream.
Who doesn't? Alright.
Ice, baby.
Ice blank, Smitty. Ice your dick.
Simple, I just said ice cube.
Ice cube. Wow. It's one of my favorites.
Everybody uses it every day.
I said ice cream. Ice cream. Looks like people are riding a train. Guess who, Smitty?
Yep.
I think they're in collaboration together. I think guest 9557, maybe Kate or somebody. Could be Natas hanging out with SJ, but they're in collaboration somehow, and it's going to turn out to be a giant.
Well, they're running out in the lead there now. That's 12-12. Nate went with 3. Smitty with 2. Minnesota not even interested in playing. Fuck this game.
Look at him. Nuh-uh. Not me. No, Lord. All right, you ready?
Yep.
Blank knife. K-N-I-F-E. Blank knife.
Blank 12-12 to 3-2. Guest 9557, who is anonymous, and SJ, Sticky Jello, tied for the lead.
All right.
Blank knife.
Blank knife, Smitty.
I said OJ Simpson.
OJ Simpson.
OJ Simpson
used a knife is a great answer. I said buck knife.
Good.
Hey, Braden, what kind of knife do you have? I got a goddamn certified Swiss buck knife coming out there from Landland. Anybody say buck knife?
No.
Jackknife, jackknife.
Who the fuck is going to say buck knife?
You never owned a buck knife?
Yeah.
I still own a buck knife.
Me too.
Okay, well, you know what a buck knife is.
Yeah, but who's going to say that?
A goddamn redneck.
Stop whining.
Get your buck knife out.
Buck knife from the dollar store, see?
I got him. I got you.
See, everybody knows what a buck knife is.
It ain't very sharp.
You get it? A buck knife costs $1.
Dollar. Buccaneer.
Ah, ha, ha. That's a good one.
Good, good, good.
That's a good one.
Pretty good, pretty good, pretty good. Very, very, very good.
Better, good.
All right, I didn't do all that. Good. Son of a bitch.
Still 12-12 to 3-3. It may end this way.
Next one. How many points is this
one? Seven.
Good blank. Good blank.
Good golly, Miss Molly. I love that. We were just talking about
good
times.
Blank.
Spinner!
Spinner! She's a spinner, dude! Good blank, Smitty. Good weed is expensive. That is so true, Smitty. Smoke true? Smoke true. Good times, kids!
Yeah.
Good times!
We were talking about it. The only one.
Very good.
That's a good one.
That gets him in the game with 10.
Yeah, he's back in it.
Still, SJ and the anonymous guest 9557 both have 12.
Alright, I have 1, 2, 3 left.
Good blowjobs come before marriage. I agree with that. I don't have any weed, but I've heard good weed is expensive.
All right, ready?
Yep.
We went with good. Bad blank. Bad blank.
Song, right?
Yeah, it was a movie too.
Bad Boys.
It was actually two,
what you gonna do?
Two different movies. The first one was Sean Penn when he was a kid in a prison kind of deal, and the second one was Martin Lawrence and the other dude.
Yeah,
the two dudes
Will
that
Smith.
Look like black guys. Bad blank, Smitty.
All right, he just said good, right?
Yes.
Good blowjobs come before marriage. Bad blowjobs come after marriage.
I said way off blank. I said bad check. Bad check.
Who writes checks anymore?
Woo!
Kids from today don't even know about checks.
I realized after I wrote it. Damn, I forgot. Nobody writes checks.
That shit's old, man.
There was actually a lady writing a check in front of me in the grocery store the other day, and I just looked at her like, you've got to be kidding me.
People still do that.
You've got to be kidding me. Yeah, all right. 9 points, here we go. Dr. Blank. Dr. Blank.
Doctor Who. Doctor Who. That's a good tune.
Dr. Blank. 10 seconds. Man, there's some good ones on here. What the fuck is a check?
Dr. Phil.
Dr. Phil. Dr. Feelgood. Dr. No, bitches.
Dr. Phil. This ain't my first rodeo.
Dr. Phil. I want you to start living as a gay woman. Who is this again? Dr. Phil?
This ain't my first rodeo.
This ain't my first rodeo. He agreed that you smoked.
Dr. Phil.
Dr. Phil. Dr. Hook. Wow.
I love Dr.
Hook. Dr. Blank.
Sylvia's
Smitty.
Mother.
Let's see. Dr. Aculo.
Dr. Aculo. I got you. Dr. Aculo.
You
Oh, Dr. Acula.
I can't fucking breathe.
I knew you were going to do that. I'm like, he's going to do that for sure.
Oh, my God. Fucking Dr. Acula. Oh, Jesus Christ. I wish I'd have said fucking. I'm fucking crying.
Dr. Acula right there.
Oh, Jesus. I can't even stand up anymore.
Oh. It's Dr. Hook. Dr. Who. That's Dr. Acula. What did he cure? Was he on that general hospital?
Was he on my medical plan, Dr. Acula?
I'm going to look it up. If there's one out there, I swear. I don't care what he is, I'm going to see him.
Oh, shit, you're killing me with fucking Dr. Acula.
He did blood transfusions.
Oh, God,
it's Dr. Seuss. Did anybody get that?
I don't think anybody said Dr. Seuss. Y'all said everything. But... Acula.
It's like, who the hell is that?
Dr. Seuss.
Dr. Acula? nailed me there, buddy.
Oh, God. I need air.
All right, nobody got points. That was, what, 9?
9 points wasted. No, it wasn't wasted because Dr. Acula was fucking awesome. I wish I'd have thought of G-Love. All right, give me a points update so I can catch my breath.
Guest 9557, the anonymous guest with 12, SJ, Sticky Jello with 12, Nitwit with 10.
Wow.
Smitty with 2.
This
is worth 10 points.
God damn, Smitty, that is fantastic.
Is Dr. Hook?
I can't wait to see that.
Dr. Pepper?
Nobody said Dr. Seuss, I can't believe it.
Nobody said Dr. Acula?
Nobody said Dr. Acula? He's a great doctor. I want that guy to do all my work for me.
Dr. Acula?
Hand blank.
Oh.
Hand blank.
Oh,
and blank.
Hand job.
I'll give an extra 10 seconds on this. I can tell you right now.
Hand over the goods.
I haven't yet to see the answer on this board.
Billy J.
I'll just tell y'all that right now. If y'all want to go ahead and change your answers right now, you can. I'll give you 10 seconds
hand
to change
cart.
But all y'all are wrong right now.
Hand-eye coordination.
You want to change yours?
Nope.
Okay.
Mine's very important.
Hand to God.
Hand to God.
That's a good one. Handsome.
Hand some.
Hand handsome. Hand blank, Smitty. Hand Spicoli and inhaler.
That's going to be a winner right there.
Dr. Acula said I need a fucking inhaler. I said hand wax. Nobody said hand wax, really?
What the hell is hand wax?
You ever hand wax a car before?
Well, I thought you meant wax for your hand.
Oh, my God. Woo! So, do we have a tie? I have to go to a tie now?
Yeah, we have a tie.
All right, so I have to go to a tie. Here we go. This is the tie. It's worth 11
points. Look at Minnesota, huh?
Hand,
hand wax,
that's
huh?
Car wax, you moron.
Jesus Christ, Spicoli.
What show is this? All right, you ready? 11 yep. points. Everybody's pretty much still in it, kind of. You ready?
What the fuck is hand wax?
Time blank. Time, T-I-M-E, blank. What the fuck is hand wax? Time blank, 11 points. Dr. Acula said... The minute I read it, I knew it was wrong. By then, it was too late. Did you mark that one too, Kirk? Jesus Christ. He started reading them off the other night, all the ones I've been saying lately. Time. I see time in a bottle. Good job, Jost. I said that in my first course.
Yeah.
You ready? Time blank, Smitty. Time to get some hand wax.
Time to go get some hand wax.
Nitwit with timeout. I said time machine. Time machine. Time traveling. Time warp? No. No. None of those qualify. I'm going to have to celebrate with
Very good.
Spicoli will be
Sticky Jello and anonymous guest 9557. Although you may know their identity,
I don't. Sticky Jello, tonight. So there you go.
They're on the same train,
they're
is what
on
you're
the
saying.
Same train. They've been riding that train.
Ride the tracks.
You can ride the train later as we go shopping with Craig when we come back. Right now, we're going to take a quick break and talk about a few things and do traffic and weather, of course. So, y'all stick around. I'll be back in a minute. Don't go far. Don't go scuba diving. Don't go playing with yourself. Look good on the highway.
Woo!
Checking in with you for your traffic report. I'm cruising around on the scooter as usual, my friends. And all the big bridges seem to be okay today. All the major roadways are good as well. I'm currently cruising up and down I-75 right now on the scooter. I'm actually cruising around the emergency lane. Of course, the scooter doesn't go past 45 miles an hour, and I have to cruise in this... Hey! Get out of the way, road ranger! You see me moving, don't you? Hogging up my lane! God damn it, I hate when I have to swerve up. Oh my God! Oh, God, I almost hit a possum! Oh Lord! Frankie, this interstate is dangerous, so I'm bringing you my traffic report. I don't see any. Well, there's a wreck up ahead! Oh yeah! Oh boy, we got major issues on I-75 north of Highway 54! and there's a lot of traffic backing up right now. I can't see the actual wreck, but I see cars stopped in the middle of the road, brake lights everywhere. Oh my God! Hey, lady, get out of my way! Oh God, I can't take this anymore. I'm gonna pull off the exit. This one's for you, buddy, you son of a bitch. There's your traffic report. We'll see you next week on Spicoli TV Radio. God damn it! Get out of the way!
Hey, it's Spicoli. Just a reminder, listen to Spicoli TV every Friday night, 9 p.m., right here on IRNBroadcast.com.
It happens every time at least once during our undercover operation. Two guys showing up almost at the same time.
Hey, come on in!
Hello?
Hey!
Hey, baby.
So glad you made it.
Ooh, baby. Come to Butthead.
Hey, I made some frozen lemonade.
Thank you.
Settle down, Beavis.
So what do you want to do?
We want to meet chicks. Yeah, and score. Yeah, I'd like to meet you. Yeah,
awesome.
Yeah.
I wanted to get into something sexier for you, and I was thinking it'd be really, really hot if you got in the hot tub and waited for me.
Wait a minute. I have a special deal for you. It's in my pants.
I'm, gonna go get in my swimsuit. Is that okay?
Dun, 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 dun.
What's up?
Hey, what are you doing?
No hug for me?
Yeah,
why don't you have a seat right over there on the other side, please?
Yeah, sit, boy. Sit or I'll kick your ass.
What are you up to?
Get us some porn. Yeah. Come on, let's check it out. Come on. Butthole.
I'm Chris Hansen with Dateline NBC.
So, how do we get porn?
I'm sorry?
Porn is good for you. Did you know that?
You show up with beer, you show up with condoms. After a sexually charged online conversation, you say, I'm big. Hee hee. I want to wrestle you so freaking bad. Hee hee.
This is stupid.
I would love to taste you. I'm bored and horny.
Hey, what are you doing? He's trying to touch my wiener. Let go, pervert. You're not supposed to touch him. It's like against the law or something.
I'm sorry?
Don't touch me, asswipe.
Well, there's something you gotta know.
Oh, yeah?
I like to make love.
Okay.
So you're excited too?
Okay, dude. Push.
All the way.
Yeah.
Wrestle me.
After we get out of here, can you help us get some more porn?
Hey, how you doing, kids? It's Tony Gorgonzola checking in with you for your irrelevant weather report for the weekend. This time we're bringing it back to the United States, my friends. We're going down to Texas. At old El Paso. No, actually, we're going to Laredo, Texas. Right off the border of Mexico there. You gotta watch out for them freaky Mexicans. Alright, they're calling for a high around 95, 96 degrees. And lows at 76 or so. We're looking at around 40% participation going on there. It might rain, it might not. You don't want to get wet, don't go outside. You gotta watch out for the Mexicans who come around. They're gonna steal your Parmesan. They're gonna steal your beefaronis. They're gonna steal your SpaghettiOs. Because why? They're trying to get in the country to get themselves a green card, them lazy bastards. So if you see a Mexican, kick his ass back over the border. I'll see you next week right here on Spicoli TV Radio, you mamalukes.
Good afternoon, Evans. Christopher and speaking. Yes?
Hello, my name is Becky.
Yeah?
Hi, can you help me?
Yeah.
What did you say your name was again?
Eamon.
Hi, Eamon.
Can I help you?
You work with tires, don't you?
We do, yeah. Can I help you?
Do you sell tires?
Of course we sell tires. Can I help you? What do you want?
Do you buy them?
Do we buy tires?
Let me tell you what it's all about. My dad said that my mum has a spare tire, and she gets upset. Amen.
What'd you say? Your mum has a spare tire? What's wrong with the point? You know she needs a new tire? What's wrong with it?
It's around her belly.
It's around her belly.
Will you buy her spare tire offer?
Yeah, I will. €70. Come here at 3 o'clock and I'll give you €70 for the tire on your ma's belly, okay?
Okay.
Okay.
Eamon, are you married?
Am I married? No, oh. I'm not married. Why?
Do you have a girlfriend?
I do. Why?
Would you ever say to her that she's a spare tire?
No, no.
Why not?
Because she definitely hasn't got a spare tire.
Would you give out to you?
For what?
For saying that about her.
Saying what about her?
That she has a spare tire.
I just said she hasn't.
Whatever, Eamon.
What do you mean by a spare tire?
She got a bit of extra flesh around her middle.
Ah, my girlfriend's nothing like that. My girlfriend's not fat at all.
Are you in love?
Ah, definitely.
How long have you been together?
5 years.
What was the last romantic thing you did for her?
The last romantic... I bought her flowers last week.
Do you think that's enough?
Depends what you're into, you know. Some people are very materialistic like yourself there. Wants a lot more than others.
5 years is a very long time.
I know.
Are you going to pop the question?
Not at the moment, we can't. Situations, I can't go into it, it's kind of private. So, have you got a boyfriend?
No, I'm hoping to get one for Christmas.
Are you?
Yep. Do you think Santa will bring me one?
Oh, you never know. He might. Who's paying for this phone call?
You are, Eamon.
I am. No, I can't pay for this phone call. You ring me. I didn't ring you.
It's reverse charges.
It's reverse charges. You see, in the reverse charges, the operator has to ask me do I want to accept. And I didn't get anything like that.
Your girlfriend didn't get a question either.
What question?
Will you marry me?
She never asked me.
Eamon, you're the best man ever.
I know I am.
You're some catch.
I'm some catch. Yeah, I'm ready to go now, okay? I have to go back to work.
Okay.
If you still want to come up at 3 o'clock, I'll buy the tire off you for €70, okay?
Yeah, but I'm not sure she'll fit in the car.
Ah, put it on the roof. You can bring her up to me.
Okay, so...
I'll give you €70. You can use it for Christmas to buy your Christmas presents or something like that.
Eamon, you rock.
Yes, so do you.
See you
then, bye.
Bye.
This is SJ, and you're watching Spicoli TV.
Yeah, what he said.
Dressed kind of like Merlin.
Bozo the Clown.
And he used to come out and he used to go, doody, 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 do. He wore a fucking medallion around his neck. I can't remember his name.
It's so funny to think that when we were young, we were amused by clowns.
Yeah. Now we don't like clowns. Really. Just clowns freak me the fuck out.
Yeah.
I don't like clowns, dude.
I'm not into clowns anymore either. They're no longer that little kid's party.
Poltergeist started it.
Well.
Damn clown, stupid clown running across, disappearing.
Now them waxing with the chopping
then
people's
heads. Then Stephen King did it with it, with the fucking clown living in the sewer.
Yeah, nah. Now they got them jagged teeth, man.
That's what I'm saying.
That's scary shit.
That's like the bad clown from Killer Clowns from Outer Space.
He was bad. That was freaky.
Good movie, though.
Have to kill it. You got to kill it.
Mm-hmm. Right in his popcorn head.
I mean, you got to sever that head.
With my brand new hacksaw. Cut it right off.
I still sleep one eye open after that. That'd be... He might come back, man. That was some weird shit.
I don't like clowns. Whatever happened to all those clown reports?
They're done, man. Imagine all these old men with clown suits hanging in their closet. Oh,
I'm never out of again. A job. Well, the good clown right now is that damn guy on
On The Simpsons.
You can't even sell a clown costume on eBay.
Nobody wants them.
That's what I mean.
Even the sad clown nobody wants.
No.
And he made millions for that painting, right?
Yeah.
Wasn't that like a Rembrandt or something?
No, that was Johnny.
Johnny Clown?
Yeah.
Dr. Oculus friend?
A mental illness, said the jobless clown.
I think you have to have a mental illness.
They do. A clown? Come on. You don't even see them over in Times Square. Triangle.
Yeah, because they're run off by all the other characters. Because
they're
Iron
weird.
Man and, yeah, all the other people dressed up in costume aren't weird. Hi, I'm SpongeBob. Hi, SpongeBob. How long have you lived in your mom's basement?
I don't know. I've been going on about 5 years now.
I don't live in my mom's basement, and I have a house.
I have moved out. She lives in my basement.
Liar.
It's her house, but she lives there.
Last year. Nah.
I'm moving out.
We'll be going there soon.
Yeah.
Metricon's not that far away.
Yes. Oh, that reminds me. While we're doing the after show tonight, don't let me forget to put the camera on reserve.
Yes.
That has to be done tonight, so.
What day is that again?
It's like 2 weeks away. So we're closing in on it.
I thought it was late.
No, it's the first week of August. It's August 5th.
No way.
Yes, it's 2 weeks away. I'm telling you. I know for a fact.
That's what Billy said, 2 weeks.
Yep. Huh. Damn Skippy.
Okay.
So there. How you like them apples? You like apples?
Yeah, they're okay.
Well, they're okay.
Apple cobbler's pretty good.
Apple cobbler's pretty good. Especially, you know, after you... Yeah, that's
when you get the
Station 51 KMG 365.
Sprinkles are for winners.
Yes, they are every time.
Sprinkles are for winners.
Every fucking time.
So all right. How does pussy feel? Feels like apple pie.
Apple pie.
And he walks by, sees that apple pie, he's like, you know, we've all been there.
I got to know.
He
was like the black guy in the fucking Clint Eastwood movie. I gots to know. Did you fire 6 shots of 5?
You know, in all the excitement, I kind of forgot myself.
Oh, Agnes over there has been pouring my coffee for 12 years. She put sugar in my coffee. I don't like sugar in my coffee. Agnes is having a bad day. And so are you.
We're just not going to let you walk out of here.
Who is we, sucker?
Name that movie.
Tick, 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 tick. Tick, 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 tick. Tick, 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 tick.
All right, so what do you got, sir?
I have a news story that I saw that broke this week, and I thought we'd share it with the fine folks at home.
This is about the guy that drove on the beach at 100 miles an hour.
Oh, did you see that crazy fucking...
Yeah, is that what
drinking and driving and...
Hell
running,
yeah!
Running over fucking beach chairs and shit.
Fucking rally, man!
What a fucking nut job. I was like, what is this guy's problem?
Yeah.
No, this is actual having to do with movies.
Movies?
This is a clip...
Porn that, movies?
This is a clip
real
of a movie that was a top movie.
Uh-huh.
And this is a clip that was taken out of the movie. And it's been surfaced... And they want to share it with people. So here you go.
Debbie Does Dallas?
No, not Debbie Does Dallas.
Okay.
More like, we'll just let you see. It has to do with rawr.
Wizard of Oz?
No. That would be more like, pluma, pluma. I'll fight you over here.
Content may contain elements that are not suitable for some audiences. Viewer discretion is advised.
Pay close attention, my friends. Spicoli TV breaking news story. Let's just in. Lion King footage. It's in the news.
Lion
See if you can spot the scene of his cuts. Alright? So you point it out to him.
He's coming up here in a minute.
You think?
Pretty sure we're almost there. I couldn't tell either. That's where I cried.
I can't wait to watch it all over again.
I cried right at
that
moment.
Can you feel the love?
That's where Phil Collins cut in, right there.
Well, I thought America needed to see that and needed to know how Nala and Simba felt about each other. And all along, they're Spicoli TV fans.
You know what I got out of that?
What?
That phrase is real. Hit it and get it. Or get it and hit it. Hit it and get it.
He gave her the old. He was getting ready to go.
I'm out of here.
Looked like a liberal convention where I got fucked again.
Damn politicians.
It was Elton John, not Phil Collins, Smitty.
They both had something to do with that.
They both had something to do with it. I figured Smitty got a hard-on from that.
It actually made me feel a little guilty, if you want to know the truth.
I actually thought it was more, it would have been better if we played the bear.
I kind of saw how humiliating that really is, man. I'm like having some flashbacks.
She's going to hurry up.
I know, but damn.
Hurry up, get done already. I got things to do.
It's almost illegal. It was almost like a... That was almost a rape.
It was almost a rape?
I'm thinking that looked like a rape. Let me hold you down and get you.
All I know is we had a quote from the lion himself, or from the female, and she said this right after the incident.
I just got fucked in the ass by Spicoli TV.
I thought you were going to go. That was huge. Felt like you could have went a couple different ways with that one.
I could have. Yeah. That tiger, that lion had a giant. That lion had a penis. Penis.
Whales do.
You're going to know you was fucked by a whale. You totally know you were fucked by a whale.
There's only one animal a whale
can... From inside your computer, it's
We've said it here before on the show. There's only one animal that would rape you and you would really know you're being raped by, and that's a gorilla. There's no tender loving with a gorilla.
You don't survive that.
No, he's just going to... He's going to violate the shit out of you, man.
It's like prison
He's
sex times 10.
He's gonna spread jelly in his ass and make you lick his gorilla ass.
That really, if that's on video, that could be brutal.
And he drills one at big right. It is high.
Not
it is far.
Ass
it is
look.
Gone.
You like peanut butter and jelly.
All right. There you go. Well, we thought we'd bring you some kind of information.
I am fucking jux.
Wow. That looked illegal. I almost need a shower after watching that.
I think so, too. It was a little messy.
And not for all the right reasons.
I think she needed a shower, too. Because, woo!
She needs a rape kit. Swab me!
Swab that lion, will ya? Yuck!
It was him!
Oh, yuck. All right, well, let's go shopping.
Hey, man, wanna play a game? Cool, let's make it!
No.
Hey, how you doing? My name's Craig. And every week I like to take articles out there, find out that Craigslist. And I'm
going to
see if I can find me something that I need. I could use a new tractor seat. See, mine got all worn out in the sun and I need a new one. So I was looking in there and I figured, well, if there's other items in there, maybe I could use one too. Something like a orange juicer or a vacuum cleaner. I don't know. Pull out your wallet, bitches. Let's go shopping with Craig.
Reno.
Is it this where O.J. Simpson is going to get a job?
I think so.
In Reno?
Reno 911.
At that bunny ranch. As a greeter.
As a greeter?
Greet all the clients that
come
in.
Welcome to the bunny ranch. My name's O.J. Have you killed anybody today?
Look at all these women. Ain't one of them been mean to me yet.
OJ's been shopping with Craig.
I'll have two of those for $500. All right, you ready? Speaking of OJ.
The stamp receiver of 5.56 NATO caliber front sight block gas block combination 500 millimeter rear sight cleaning rod back. Jesus Christ. Polymer furniture, stainless steel heat shield, left side folding polymer stock, two Bulgarian clips included. I missed my ex-wife, but my aim is getting better.
Aim's getting better.
You can hit anything with this gun. I'm thinking a gun like this. Mom's is not on tonight, so I can burp all I want.
That's true.
Watch her come on as a guest and go, stop it, Spicoli. I think we got some good ones so far. $69. Anybody say $1? Anybody got any balls?
Woo! Woo!
All right, ready?
To the winner, go with the spoil. $900, kids. Spicoli, you will pick. Nitwit will share. Seems to know his armed weapons.
I know my weapons, Dan.
I know my weaponry.
They're all up there.
Do you want to do that thing?
That thing? We've never had that. Well, this is the first.
We're going to go opposites.
Do that thing you do. You always get that.
Hello, Dr. Acula. Dr. Acula, how the fuck does this happen? I'm sharing points with Nitwit as it stands, correct?
Yep, you both have one.
Now I'm tied with the son of a gun.
Yep, you are.
That was
a waste.
Pretty good, pretty good, pretty good. Very, very, very good. I shot myself in the foot. We both still have 1 point.
That was close.
Dr. Acula. Please help Dr. Acula.
You ready?
It's a Superman cape. Adult-sized Superman cape worn once, cleaned and ready for your adventure. It's a little wrinkly, if you ask me. High quality, looks new, would also work for Superwoman costume. If you wear this, bullets will bounce off your chest
But you better duck if they throw the gun at you. Why did he always do that?
Take
the bullets off the chest, but they throw the gun, he's got to duck. Hello? Hello, you're Superman.
Weren't those just bullets?
I know they're rubber and all. $12.
Remove URL?
Yeah, because they probably put a dot in there. Don't put a dot in your number because it thinks you're putting in a .com. So just put your number in. If you're using dollars and cents, use a spacer.
Sprinkles are for winners.
10 seconds. Guess 7611.
That's a nice cape.
That is a nice cape.
If you come home and put that on and go to your wife, she's got to fuck you. You're Superman.
You could Superman that hoe.
I'm Superman.
You could literally Superman
literally.
That hoe. Just blow it all over that and paste it right on her back.
Fall asleep right with that cape
I
on.
I just Superman that hoe.
Wake up the next morning going, yes, I did. Yes, I did.
You have a Superman cape stuck to your ass.
Yep.
Stop whining.
Stop whining and deal with it.
Why are you smiling? All right, you ready?
Superman cape. Cape.
Smitty cape.
$10. RF Tech. Oh, nitwit.
Warning.
RF
Warning.
Tech and Geo
Warning.
Will share the
Goba alert. Goba alert.
Dead on balls accurate. Dead on balls accurate. It's an industry term.
Number 7. Oh, he's
going right to left.
I think we started something here. I think we started something here. I'm sorry, bro. It's not a good pick at all. It's a fucking great pick. You got the damn dilly double
wow.
right off the bat. Holy shit.
Good. Very good.
Game over. Wow, three-way tie.
No. Nitwit has 22 because he already had a point.
Yes.
RF Tech and Geo both have 21.
There you go. They're 1 point behind.
So right there. Still have a long ways to go, people.
Long ways.
Good. Very good. Very good.
This one, a cabinet. Oh, does that 1975 TV come with it?
It sure does. You go ahead and read that.
Light Oak Entertainment Center, an older Panasonic TV. Older, just says older. Both in very good condition. Has a VCR rack on the top, and the TV works well on most channels. Because, of course, it's analog.
Hey, the TV.
It's not set up for digital.
Woo!
I'm trying to put a digital signal through an analog TV.
That's a nice cabinet, though, man.
It is a
solid
nice
wood.
Yeah. I'd store my weed in there.
And think, which drawer did I put that in again?
I have behind the TV sometimes. $75. $151.25. Need gone. Free, says Jost. Nitwit.tv says 50, 70, and a 75. It's a far cry. They are missing out selling that TV to hipsters. No shit. You can sell it to Raymond's Hipster Store.
Yeah, we actually make video games out of those.
Mm-hmm.
Nice. You ready?
Good stuff. All right, here we go.
See who's closest.
Free! Free! Oh, my God. Just!
SJ.
Warning. Warning.
SJ is
alert.
He's gone. Go
bust.
Alert. Is 150.
You are correct. I didn't see his first bid.
So his second bid doesn't count. Jost said free.
Jost
is the winner, my friend.
Good, good, good. Pretty good, pretty good, pretty good.
Warning.
Very, very, very good.
Warning. You're right, man.
Warning.
GeoBot
alert.
GeoBot alert.
Tower 1, I said nothing.
I didn't say shit. It's an industry time. Jost is going. Jost is... No, SJ, you gave a bid of 150.
You gave an early bid of 150, and then you said need gone. So we have to take your first bid.
We have to take the first bid.
That's part of the rules, my friend. I'm sorry.
Jost, all right, number two.
Number two. Add 5 points to that score.
That's six. 22 to 21. It's six. It's right there.
I have one, right?
Spicoli has 1 point.
Yeah,
and,
I have one.
SJ has none. Anybody's game.
All right.
There's a lot of good stuff up here. All the names are left.
I see that.
Nobody chose to go with a name.
I see that. And all the names are in the middle.
I don't even think they can read them. Can you read them? Can y'all tell what they say?
I need new glasses, so I'm really having a hard time reading.
That lighting sucks.
I saw a picture of some lion's balls in my face, so I don't know what's... Damn, did I just say that?
Was Cabo?
Lion's balls in my face. I did say that, right? Son of a bitch. I hate this show. Did you jot that one down too, Kirk?
Good, good, good. Pretty good, pretty good, pretty good. Very, very, very good.
All right, here we go. Next item. It's a good one.
Hair tools. Look at those. All are new. Wait. All are new or used a few times. Round brush is a hair dryer and an ionizer. All work like new. The hair dryer is new. You cannot find this deal anywhere. Vidal Sassoon, Revlon, Conair, John Frieda. My wife died, so I'm getting rid of all her crap.
Well, since it's crap, $50.
Crap.
Well, now that you put it that way, and it's crap.
Crap. I thought about creating a username Mr. Hand and coming in here, but somebody already did that. I don't see a Mr. Hand in here, so what do you mean?
Somebody else, maybe. Got it. I'm sure somebody has it somewhere, you know.
Oh, somebody already has it. I imagine they do. The ionizer will get rid of your weed smell.
You got to put the space in there, two spaces before you put Mr. Hand, and then it'll come up.
It might.
It will.
It might. It might be like Mr. Hand 69 or something. Who knows? All right. I'm a pubic hair tools.
People still have that?
Do they still use that? I should make the name Dr. Acula. I'm telling you, Dr. Acula is the name of tonight's show for damn sure. By all means, Dr. Acula will be tonight's show name. That's a fucking...
Woo!
Throw a vibrator in for free.
They could.
That one looks like a vibrator.
I'm sure it's used as one. You know, in a pinch.
All right, $40. Geo with $40.
Geo had 45, closest one.
Geo said number one. You go with the dilly.
The dilly.
The dilly one. Dilly one.
Geo is now tied for first place with 22 points.
Give any other player 10 points.
Good, good, good. Pretty good, pretty good, pretty good. Very, very, very good.
But Geo, this will not help your score, but you can just hand out 10 points to anybody you want.
You're now tied with Nitwit. Both have 22 points. RF Tech has 21. Jost with 6. Spicoli with 1. Chocto not on the board.
Yep. Chocto's not on the board.
You got to give anybody, somebody 10 points.
Just hand out 10 points to anybody.
Minnesota, anybody.
What do you think of Jim? Who has 0?
Minnesota's 1.
Minnesota has 0. Sticky Jello.
Pretty much everybody, Geo. Yeah,
pretty much everybody, Geo.
Okay. Me, me, me. Look at me. I don't even play this fucking game.
Me, me, me. No, over here. Me. Y'all all beg Geo right now. Minnesota's gonna get it, he said. So our man...
Minnesota, baby!
Minnesota will get the points.
Minnesota, nice. Baby!
Look at Billy. Me, me, me!
Minnesota, baby! Minnesota, right, baby!
This next item, I think, is really cool. I think
the next item up for bids. Oh, the price is wrong, Bob.
I think you're gonna wanna... I think you're gonna wanna get this, man. I think you'd buy this.
Okay. Is it a sex doll, Smitty? I need a new one. Pedal cars, those are cool. We have two slightly used pink pedal cars. Those are pink?
Yeah.
Excellent condition, approximately 2 years old, and there are very few scuffs and scrapes, but overall excellent condition. The cars are pink, but lightning is horrible. My lightning Dr. Acula is terrible. Seats are in great shape, no rips or tears. These metal pedal cars would make a great photo prop as well. Manufacturer recommended ages 3 through 6. Weight capacity 66 pounds. This sucks.
Hot puppy.
Because I would like to take a photo in one of these, and I weigh a little hot more puppy than 66 pounds. I've got to get in the car to get my picture taken. I want a 3 on there to make it look like Dale Earnhardt's car, and I want to get inside of it. I'm saying $279.99.
Good, good, good. Very good, very good, very good. Very, very, very good.
I didn't even see Kirk's bid of $300.
$279 minus $99.
No, $279.99.
Oh, okay. RF Tech with the $350.
All right. Pedal your ass off in a pedal car that you can't sit in because you're too fat. You look like a gopher in a pink car anyway. Here we go. Put your little doggy in there. $340. $340. RF Tech, sir.
Wow, he ties for the lead. Three-way tie, 22.
Wow.
And he gets the pick.
Number 5.
The Jugs.
Number 5. Johnny 5 is alive.
Jugs.
No disassemble.
Uh-oh. What? This could be tough.
This could be tough. This is tough.
It is tough.
I hate telling people this. I really do. Lose all your points.
Damn it.
You got there and...
First to worst.
Yeah.
Boom! You blew up your engine!
That's too quick.
Sprinkles are for winners.
But it's not over.
You blew your wad before your engine got hot.
It went out. But that doesn't mean it's over.
That doesn't mean it's over. You could be like me and only have 1 point.
You gotta do is next one. It's all about the next one, right?
That's true. No disassemble. Yard art. This is a Dr. Acula production. Perfect for the sporting family. This is an excellent piece named Die Duck Die. It is 5 foot tall and solid metal. The piece is from Braden Gunn's personal collection, and this is one of a kind paint in excellent condition. Oh my god, we are calling Braden fucking Gunn right now. I don't have his phone number on the goddamn phone.
That's damn hilarious right there.
You're gonna have to call Brayton.
That dude's sitting on a log.
Brayton, I had no idea you had your own damn log art. We gotta find Brayton Gunn right here. I got his phone number right here somewhere. Let's see, there he is.
He might be live right there on one of these guests.
On his phone. We're gonna call Braden Gunn right now. We gotta find out. All right, here we go. Do I have to dial a one? Yes, I do.
See if we can get the owner of this piece of art. It's a gentleman with a red shirt with a gun sticking right up a duck's ass. He's got that gun up that duck's ass.
He does have that gun up his duck ass. Come on, Brayden, answer the phone.
Or is it a goose? Got my goose. He's already in bed. He's got to be up at 3:30 in the morning to do a radio show.
He does have to get up early. He's not up that early. He's not up.
Your call has been forwarded to an automated voice messaging system. 7-2
Blah, 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 blah. All right. Well, we couldn't leave a message for old Brayden. Damn it. Ha, bitch.
Sprinkles are for winners.
We're going to ask you, what kind of duck, motherfucker? How fast does this duck fly? Yard art by David.
$88 is all you put?
Brain gun. Yeah, that was it. That's all I could come up with. $88.
Okay, you ready?
It's a specialty. Special art.
You ready?
Yep. $340? Wow! Wow! Our winner is 7611 with $350.
Yes.
7611, guess 7611 with the bid of $350. You missed it by 10, but you will take the
win.
Please pick an envelope.
Pick an envelope. We have 3, 6, 9, 10, and 4.
And da, 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 da. All right, we're going to give you 10 seconds and then we're going to pick for you. I'm going to pick
for you. But you know what? Say the whole number real quick. Maybe they don't look at it that way.
Guess number 6738143955 7.
No.
No? Guess number 925-614-47611.
Yeah, Ma.
Ma.
M-A.
Ma, you're up. Please pick.
Yeah, M-A.
M-A.
M-A. You pick any envelope. 3, 6, 9, 10, or 4. M-A are letters. We need a number.
Yes.
Now, think about what M-A could be. That could be Ma. Babe killed Ma.
Babe killed Ma. Number 3.
Way over here.
Way down yonder.
You know how these things have names on it,
right?
Last week, something pretty cool happened, right?
Yeah.
We named a new champion.
That's right, we did. We named a new Snapple champion.
His number was what?
345.
I think since they picked number 3 tonight, I think we should honor number 3 and make it the Geo 3.
The Geo 3 envelope?
The Geo 3. What do you think?
Wow. Does anybody feel the same way about that?
I think we should do it.
It's our show, right?
That's right.
Well, Geo.
The Geo 3. Sounds like a pretty cool band, actually.
The Geo envelope is officially number 3. The Geo 3.
Minnesota doesn't even have an envelope.
I know. We should honorize him.
With the Hall of Fame.
Well, he's definitely in the Hall of Fame. Nobody else is.
We got to put his name at the bottom of every one of the envelopes.
Yeah, I agree. You get to...
And guess 7611, M-A, which could be Maryland, Maine, Massachusetts, Minnesota. Could be a number thing. Maybe that's Mrs. Minnesota.
Could be my ass hurts.
That could be Mrs. Minnesota.
It could be Mrs. Minnesota.
Never thought of that.
But I doubt it could be.
Bro, she's eating those delicious meals he's making.
It's true.
I mean, she's taking care of him.
She's true.
All right.
Probably taking care of them right now.
So Newit has 22. Geo has 22. RF Tech, who had 22, now has 0. Minnesota with 10 points. Way out there with 10 points.
Way out there.
Guess 7611, Ilme with 8. Jost has 6.
Okay.
Spicoli, you're on the board.
One. I got one.
Yes.
Which one is better than usual. I usually have a big donut, babe.
All right, Brandon, donut. We appreciate you you putting up your personal collection up there. Die, duck, die.
Die, duck, die. Thanks, Braden. All right, here we go. The next one,
this is pretty
bench.
Cool.
It's a bench. What kind of a bench?
Well, you can pretty much tell.
It is a JL Crafts. We're out of Modesto, California. We make anything from wine barrels. We're coming to Reno for hot August nights so we can deliver for free if you meet us at the GSR on Thursday, August 10th, and that's where we stay. That is a new build. It is 58 inches wide in the seating area. Great looking and comfortable, very sturdy and solid. Fat chicks can use this bench for sure. Does it smell like wine? Made out of a wine barrel. It smells like wine.
You didn't notice the last two were $340, did you?
No, I didn't. I really didn't pay attention to that.
I just was wondering if you had noticed that.
Do you know a good Jewish wine? I want to go to Miami.
Good, good, good. Very good, very good, very good. Very, very, very good.
No? I thought that was a good one. Come on.
I
want to
go to Miami.
He said it again. All right. 450, 475, 376, 350, 500, 375. Bench for fat women made out of wine barrels.
It's pretty nice. Of course, your clothes turn purple after you sit on them.
That's true. She got purple.
Lucy!
Lucy! We got some explaining to do. All right. This is going to go home to the bidder who bid.
I'm trying to think, but nothing happens.
It is unique.
$125. That's it. $125.
SJ.
SJ.
Stinky Jello with 50.
Good boy, SJ. Number 69104. 10-4, buddy. He's at number 9. Ain't even playing. He's taking Nitwit's
number. Nitwit's number.
Yep. I want it. It's mine.
Take that.
Aha.
A1's always a miss.
That's right, but it's a great steak sauce.
I sank the tube boat.
Nice.
I did.
Nice. SJ, for your troubles, you get to double your points.
Good, good, good. Very good, very good, very good. Very, very, very good.
Oh, my God.
That's two more I got. Just saying.
Think about it. It is pretty cheap, but you know what they do? They just take them rings off there. They just screw them. Zoop, zoop,
yeah, that's
zoop.
All it
takes them
off.
Like 6 minutes. Yeah, barrels were free.
Yeah, barrels are free. Need a couple screws. And a fucking battery for your gun. Hey, get another one out of here. Here we go. That's fat girl friendly.
Come here, big girl. I like big girls.
Come here, Biggie. Sit on top of this motherfucker and let me see if it works. The first one to guess correctly can pick an envelope or pass the pick to any other player they wish. Is there any other show on the internet that does this?
I don't think so.
No?
I've never heard of this before.
I haven't either, and I know that it's patent pending.
It's always pending.
It's always pending. You're always abstain. All right, here we go. Down and dirty. It's a motorhome, kids. A 2018? It hadn't even been released yet?
Brand new.
Brand fucking new Thor Wind Sport Double Side Class A gas-powered motorhome bath and half floor plan. Equipments include 40-inch LCD TV in the living area, front electric down bunk, bedroom LCD TV, power patio awning, 3-burner cook range with an oven, solid surface countertop, 32-inch exterior TV, outside kitchen, outside shower, auto leveling jacks, 3 cam rear vision system, power driver seat, and of course, an Onan 5.5 kilowatt generator and more. Why don't they just say new and improved? And more. What? It's got a radio. Yeah.
Outside shower. Fuck that.
It's even got a cigarette lighter.
I ain't going out there.
It's even got windshield wipers. Yeah. There's air in the tire.
The wheels go round.
There's air in the tires. We're going to put air in there for free, kids. Oh, my God. Oh, shit, that's funny. I need one more zero on there. There you go, $112,000 stiff.
Damn!
I got $80,079.9, 150 G's flat out. Damn! 66, 123, $88,000, 125, outside shower. Fuck that! I ain't showing everybody my Johnson. I'll just see everybody inside the motorhome, my wee wee. All right, the person that bid how much for a motorhome that you're going to play Motorhead tapes over and over? $108,000, 339 to be exact. Holy shit. Glory hole included.
Warning.
Geo.
Warning.
The man Warning. Who people Doba. Say cheated Alert. Everything.
Doba.
It's a Alert. Doba. Dead on, boys. If I could Doba a Snapple, I could Doba a motorhome, bitches.
Now, I just want to point out, just so he knows, he now has 23 points. Geo has 23. Nitwit has 22. So he does have the lead by 1 point. Geo is in the lead by 1 point. Nitwit with 22.
Pick it or pass it,
Minnesota
Geo.
With 10. There's three left. Geo, pick. Or pass.
That glory hole is priceless.
He's going to give it to nitwit.tv.
Wait, hold on. Now, he's saying that Nitwit or that Geo had a previous
I see $88,000. You're right. 88 grand right there. You're right. You have to take that first bid. Well, I see a foul on the board. Foul.
Wait a minute.
Foul. I see it. Foul. I'm calling it.
He did say 88 grand.
88 grand right there. He came in right above RF Tech.
That's right. Spicoli.
Oh, wow. I've been robbed many times that way.
Geo, we got to take the first bid. That's
gotta
our rule.
Take the first
and
bid.
They are correct. So the next closest was Spicoli. So Spicoli.
Who are the Tides?
The Tides are Geo at 22 and Nitwit at 22. You have two.
I have two. Who's next in line underneath them?
Minnesota with 10. So Nitwit
no
and Geo both have 22.
There's not enough for Minnesota to pick up. So I'm going to give it to Nitwit and let him decide his fate. Nitwit, you've been such a good help.
Good, good, good. Pretty good, pretty good, pretty good.
It's your chance. Very good. Ball's in your court, my friend. You have three. Please, pick a good one. It's all you, my friend.
Woo!
For you, the show wouldn't have ran smooth tonight, so hope you pick a winner.
Don't go left. God has spoken.
God has spoken. CJ number four. All right.
That's a good pick.
I think so.
I like CJ a lot, man.
I do, too. I
now, he didn't take 10.
He didn't take number 10, and 10 would have been... negative five, so that wouldn't have hurt. That wouldn't have helped.
That would have given Geo the victory.
That would have gave Geo the victory.
He didn't pick number six.
He did not pick number six. Number six would have been take 5 points from any player.
That would have done it for him.
That would have done. But instead, you picked this one. And you are... what the fuck? Tied for first place? How is that possible? How is that possible? God,
it was meant to be.
Son of a bitch.
It was meant to be.
Son of a bitch.
The time.
Wow.
Good, good, good. Pretty good, pretty good, pretty good. Pretty good, pretty good.
We win. We win.
We win.
We win. There you go. Okay, Kirk. work. At least you didn't lose.
Fireball.
All right, it's time to get the Fireball Challenge out. If you got a drinky poo at home, put it in a shot glass. If you're a smoker, put that pack of big fat one in your bong, and let's get ready to rip it up. If you're just eating, you can eat all you want.
Fireball.
No, they're good. Okay. This week we decided, in honor of our longest listener, our greatest friend.
Yes.
The best champion ever.
The three-time woo world heavyweight champion himself, Minnesota.
The Ric Flair of Snapple Cap Facts.
Ric Flair of Snapple Cap himself.
Minnesota shot glasses.
There you go.
I'm on fire. Woo! Fire it all.
Go see Dr. Acula.
All right, Dr. Acula, Jesus Christ. Look at mine. And look at me, he's like, whoops.
A little whoop.
I'll give you a little extra.
Take that.
There once was a girl.
Who lives in a shoe.
She smokes dope.
She drinks booze.
She's not a virgin.
That's no sin.
She's still got the box.
Geo and Nitwit came in.
Congratulations, guys.
Cheers.
Woo! I may need to see Dr. Acula after that one.
Let me see. Dr. Pepper, Dr. Hook.
Woo!
That's right there with the three greats.
Yeah. Dr. Acula, Dr.
Pepper, and Dr. Hook.
And Dr. Cockblocker.
Dr. Who?
No, Dr. What's his name? The urologist Cockburn. Never go see that guy. All right, we're going to run over, do the Twisted Topics, come back and do round two of Snapple. Guess the flavor. Get an extra. All right, be right back. Don't go far.
Fire it all.
Woo!
No!
I mean...
TV newsroom live in the shed with your half-blind, deaf, gray-haired geriatric correspondents, Buddy and Harry. The Twisted Topics.
Ready?
All right, hey, welcome back to Twisted Topics.
That's what it's called?
Something like that.
I keep forgetting the name.
Well, you know, that's what happens when you're old and you don't take your ginkgo biloba.
I need that ginkgo biloba stuff.
You keep forgetting to take it.
Yeah, it costs a lot of money, too.
If you would remember to take it, you wouldn't forget.
I gotta keep the Viagra going. I can't afford ginkgo biloba. Yeah, can't have erection and memory, too.
You want ginkgo to blow ya, get it?
I take the blow ya.
Hello? Yep. I see you down there.
Who loves that?
Yep, still tying your shoes. Okay. Well, this week I figured we'd discuss some medical terms.
You mean like prostate exam?
Trigonosis.
Trigonosis?
Doesn't that sound horrible?
Sounds like a math class.
Yeah, I took that once in college, I think.
I majored in trigonosis.
I did it in the bathroom the other night. Yeah. I was trigonosis all over the place.
That was a clean
That's up. A rough night of some damn Taco Bell.
You're going to need a lot of bleach.
Yep. And maybe a stick-em-up or two.
You know the people that take your blood?
The blood, yeah. What do they call them?
They're called phlebotomists.
Who?
Phlebotomists.
Phlebotomists. Is that lady Flo from Progressive Insurance work for him?
Hey, Flo!
Sprinkles are for winners, bitch!
You got your botomists?
You phlebotomists? What about Flo from Mel's Diner?
I liked her.
Kiss my grits! That was great.
She was hot.
Yeah, she was.
You know she was horny.
Yeah, well, I don't know. Vera, I think, was banging Mel on the backside, I think.
Yeah, but who wants either one of them?
Nobody. Nobody wants Alice either.
Well, hey.
Early to bed.
Couple of tall
early
boys.
Early to rise.
I'm in couple of tall boys.
So what other medical terms do you know?
Angina.
My Aunt Gina?
Angina sounds like it should be good, right?
Yeah, it has Gina in it.
It's not so good.
No.
That's a heart attack.
Oh, God.
They call it angina.
Is that a heart attack in the vagina?
I'm going to give me some angina.
Wake up. Oh, my God.
Oh, I just
Now he's back. How's I thought they were pancakes.
Pancakes?
Get it? Angina.
Angina.
And Jemima. Oh, that's a totally different person.
Yeah, that's a little greasy.
Yeah, I like them. A little melted butter and some syrup on them.
What do you think of when you say the word needle?
I think of a camel.
I think of dick. You needle dick?
Needle dick. I think of a camel. You ever see the picture of the camel walking through the eye of the needle?
I have a needle.
Yep. What the hell was like? It had a saying.
Yeah, if you can fit a camel through the eye of a needle.
You can accomplish anything.
That's right.
Men who catch fly with chopstick accomplish anything.
Why is this dead camel here? He wouldn't move.
There's a dead camel Pakistani on my couch.
So I shot him.
I heard camel humps are pretty tasty.
That's good.
Yeah.
You know what a camel with no humps is called?
A dog?
A horse.
Oh, my God.
Just saying.
A horse is a horse. Well, you know what? One thing I don't want.
What?
Mononucleosis.
Mononucleosis is the kissing disease.
You know, Spicoli TV had mononucleosis for a long time. They finally got rid of it.
How? Did you get a shot?
No, I guess they changed format and it fixed it. I don't know. Now they have stereosis.
You sleep it off?
Yep, a long way, like Rip Van Winkle.
We don't know what we're doing.
What, were we supposed to show up this week?
No, it's Vincent Van Gogh.
Isn't that the guy with the ear missing?
Yeah, not Rip Van Winkle.
What? What?
Use the other ear!
What? Where'd you go? Hello? What? Well, there's lots of medical terms out there, and I just, you know, I want you to be careful.
I want to find a chick and play doctor, though.
I love playing doctor.
Hell yeah!
I was good at it.
Let me take your temperature.
That blood pressure thing was the best.
Looks good to me.
Yeah, looks great. Now let me stick this Q-tip in your ear and you'll be fine.
I think we've been rambling a little too long.
All right, so we're going to go.
Peace out.
All right.
I love you.
I love you too.
Don't.
I mean...
Kids, this week's Snapple Cap Fact coming up right now. Don't go anywhere.
Snapple Cap Fact time, kids. Snapple Cap Facts come 0 through 1,499. First one in always gets two picks. Nitwit.tv once again must have activated the Now computer as he's beating everybody to the punch.
Jost with triple eight balls.
Jost, you have 8-pound balls. How do you walk? Where do you buy your underwear?
With a limp. Now computer was activated.
I'd like a new rule. Whoever gets two picks first round doesn't get two in the second round. Nitwit.
Cheat bastard.
Guess 7611. That big dick limp. One, two, three, four. That's right. Follow me out the fucking door. I'm going to be the new champion right now. Wouldn't that be the shit?
You think
it happen.
Y'all be bowing down to the king then.
At some point, it's going to happen.
It's going to happen. You're right. All right. All the flavors are in. You ready?
Yes, we're ready.
Second round flavor is...
And he throws it in the deep right. It is high.
Snapple apple. No tea tonight. No tea tonight.
So that means nitwit.tv will get another number. And if he doesn't win, he flat out sucks. When you get three picks and you don't win.
Nitwit.tv with another pick. We'll get...
238.
We're in a glass bottle, so I'm looking for a tremendous pop here. Brother, I'm looking for a big pop, brother. So when I open up the curtain, dudes, what's going to happen, brother, is the sunshine from the Hulkamaniacs, brother. It's going to feel the pressure, dudes. You ready?
Hold on. Soda is gone.
The soda quit.
He's gone.
He's gone.
His computer died. Usually around the end of the show.
Hold on, I'll show you. You ready? You ready? I'm going to show you how funny we are. You ready? Bye! That's how funny we are! Uh-huh. How you like them apples?
Where's mom's when you need her?
Oh. That's how you do it. You just flush them right down the toilet. You ready? Much better than a plastic bottle.
That was respectable. No doubt.
That's some good shit. That's some good stuff. Yep.
And he drills
it
in the deep right.
Thank you, Nitwit.
77162.
All right, here we go. You ready? Real fact number. 1-1-6-3. Gerald Ford was the only president and vice president never to be elected to either office.
Cheating bastard.
I ain't like them apples, kids. 1-1-6-3. Gerald Ford was the only president and vice president never to be elected to either office.
The most awesome part about that is we got another one.
Pull your doors off. I'm bidding to give me some.
No, he did 1-1-2-4, though.
Oh,
but I got me a peach. I got a peach mangosteen this time. You know that? I thought I'd try.
Pull your doors off. I'm bidding to give me some.
All right. Here. It's still kind of duddish, dude.
Hold on. We're supposed to go to this cam, aren't we?
Yeah. The Snapple cam. The Snapple cam. The Snapple cam is running you and looking for you. The Snapple cam. All right. Here we go. 1-1-9-4. 1-1-9-4. What was the other one?
1-1-6-3.
Wow. Woodrow Wilson passed Georgia bar exam despite not finishing law school. He also held a PhD.
Like Nitwit.
Woodrow Wilson and Nitwit both
are brothers.
Have a PhD.
They went to college together.
PhD brothers. PhD brothers, if you will.
We went to college together.
Went to college together and everything. We
sorority brothers.
But you know what? You can't say Roll Tide in the library, but I can say it in the damn stadium. Roll Tide.
Go Gators.
Go Gators. All right, there you go.
And he drills one in deep right. It is high.
No, I like the sororities better.
It is gone.
That's where the pussy is. Anyways. Gotta go there. Rich pussy, too. Big money.
Big beaver.
Brittany's in there. She likes peanut butter. She wants a fighter jet experience. I'll give you a fucker. I'll do the fighter jet on you.
She wants me to take those new peanut butter balls and put them in different places.
No, she wants to eat them, so you got to put them. You got to.
Smitty, stop. Stop. You're giving me a...
Spicoli.
Yeah, I'm having a hard time sitting here, Smitty. I'm going to have to put a book in front of myself.
Well, believe it or not, we made it.
Yeah, we did.
We made it because of that dude over there on nitwit.tv.
Thanks to that guy and Mark Vaughn for having a
Mark
glitch-free tonight. Great Mark. Show. Mark Vaughn. Thank
Mark
you,
Green.
My friend.
Mark Green.
And nitwit.tv, you're the best, my friend. Thank you. Spot on tonight. I appreciate that.
No, he's second best. His wife's way better than him.
Well, because she's got the mountains and he doesn't.
Well, he does.
But he's got the role.
He went mountain climbing last night.
He was roping the mountains last night.
He was in the mountains last night.
He took the sausage to the mountain factory, huh?
Ole, ole, ole. He was yodeling and shit. That's when you know he's having sex. You hear that yodeling? He's fucking again. There you go, nitwit.
There you go,
Mr. Yodeler.
Nitwit.tv, Thursdays, 10 p.m.-ish. Let's run down the lineup, though. Of course, tomorrow night, 9 o'clock, show with no name. Show with no name on the nonamenetwork.net.
Yep.
Go check out Whitey and SJ as they do their show. They do a great show. They come back around on Tuesday. It's so good they do it again. Not the same show, a totally different show. I commend you guys for that. I love you for that. Wednesdays, you got Randomly Randy, which has been Randomly SJ and whoever else he can get to fill in. But it's good. He's been on the air,
yep. And
we like that.
Mm-hmm.
And then on Thursday nights, of course, you got Open Mic at 7, and then Nitwit.tv, 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 10 p.m.-ish Thursdays. The finest produced show I've seen yet.
Now, these are great shows in itself, but if I really wanted to go somewhere to find, like a shitload of great shows, where would I go?
A shitload of podcasts and
whatnot. A shitload of all that kind of stuff.
IRNbroadcast.com.
Damn it.
50-plus shows on there.
Wow.
I mean,
how does that happen?
Because Mike Peter's the man, and he knows how to get shit done.
You have to be a genius, I think.
I think the guy is a fucking genius.
I think he's a genius.
He's so well-endowed with that.
He's well-endowed? Hey, mark
God
that.
Son of a bitch.
When we put that right on the one about the lion dick, and then he's so well-endowed, that's just a one. That's just a winner.
He's so enamored? No, I don't know the fucking word. He's such good job at what he does. He took a vacation this week.
Thank you, guest 9557. We appreciate it.
No, thank
you. Take
care.
Thanks for hanging.
Thanks for hanging out with us. That means a lot. We really appreciate that.
We need all four of y'all to listen regularly.
If you can't remember any of these places, the easiest way is go to SpicoliTV.com on our Friends and Links page, and there's a link to every one of the shows we talked about.
Yep.
Every one of the places we talked about, there's a link to get there and go check them out.
And you know what I'm going to start
with
doing?
With a few extras.
You know what I'm going to do?
What?
I'm going to start listing the price sheet for Shopping with Craig on our website, because I bet you no one will go there to check our website, and there'll be all the answers right there. They can win the game.
He's going to put the answers right out on the
board. I'm going to put the list right on the front page
of
the website next week. I bet nobody shows up
with
the answers. I bet nobody does.
I don't think anybody will.
They won't.
No.
They never go to our website.
No. SpicoliTV.com, SpicoliTV.com.
I'm going to do that.
That's a good idea, though.
Nobody will ever.
That's
they'll
a
never
great
know.
Idea. I think
we'll know immediately. Up. Y'all are stupid.
We'll know right away.
You didn't go to the website.
You didn't go to the website. I will also put a picture of our Snapple caps. If you can guess how many are in here, we'll give you some extra picks. I'll put that on Twitter, Facebook, and the website right after we get off the air.
That jug is huge.
This jug is huge. We have an after show. Music, comedy, if you want to hang out and listen to that, you're welcome to it. We'll be on the air for at least another hour or so. So thanks for hanging with us. We'll see you next week, and we'll see you tomorrow night. Show with no name. Don't go far. And don't go scuba diving.
This is Q from Thorquay.
I know how many are in that jar.
Yep, I bet you do.
All right, kids. That's all for this week. Show.
God, I got a fat cherry red face. We're going to have to move
the show
that
is
camera,
hosted
Smitty.
By Spicoli. And hosted by my man, Smitty. Your audio director is Harry, and your video director is Brian. That's all, folks. See you next week.